Let's talk databases and how you can access and use them within Suffolk's virtual library. For those unfamiliar with the term, a database is a collection of organized data that can be accessed and searched electronically. The library has databases that store text, images, and music, though you will most often be searching for articles. One popular database we're all familiar with is Google, a database that organizes websites and allows them to be searched and accessed. These websites are created throughout the world by anyone who has access to a computer and the knowledge to do so. There are even some sites, such as wikis, that allow anyone to edit content. This may leave you wondering which of these sources you can trust to provide credible information for your research. Fortunately for you, the library subscribes to a vast number of databases that provide access to scholarly, peer-reviewed articles. Let's see where we can find them. Keep in mind that you will be asked to enter your Suffolk login and password to access them off campus. From the library's homepage, choose articles and databases to find most of these databases. Some popular multi-subject options are featured here. We'll choose Academic Search Complete. Many databases we subscribe to have a very similar interface design because they're owned by the same company, EBSCOhost. To use them, enter your topic in the first box. You'll notice that the database mimics Google in the sense that it tries to anticipate my search by providing some suggestions. To focus your search, add additional keywords in the other boxes. This database also suggests synonyms. Here I begin searching United States, and the database recommends searching United States, America, USA, and US, since they mean the same thing and omitting them would exclude relevant results. Another way to choose databases is by sorting them by subject. Click the Subject tab to select a field of interest. Note that as you begin choosing individual databases, many will look and function the same. Know that they will produce drastically different results. As articles are retrieved, you may find the need to limit them by magazines or scholarly journals, which are also known as academic or peer-reviewed. Most of us are familiar with popular magazines, as they are often colorful and written with accessible language to appeal to everyone. In comparison, scholarly journals are written and approved by scholars in one field. Language is often technical, and graphics take the form of tables and charts to convey data results. Professors often prefer the latter. To narrow these down, go to the column where you can limit results. Scroll down to select one. You may find the need for reference databases. Return to the homepage to choose Reference. Gale eBooks provides access to encyclopedias that will help define the basics of a topic, while newspaper databases make great primary sources. Current issues databases can help with persuasive arguments. Opposing viewpoints list current topics and collects various opinions and supporting documents, while CQ Researcher provides a great pro-con section. Throughout the research process, you may notice a prompt appear that asks if you require assistance. Clicking Chat Now will connect you with a librarian as long as the library is open.